me right. So that I will promise me. Spent the morning doing a drop-in session. Look at the sun again. I look like I'm radioactive. I'm shining. Which was great, exploring the qualities and properties of paint, because I was explaining to a lot of the parents and grandparents that came along with the grandchildren is, and I explained this in the workshop yesterday actually, what most people do with paints is they think they can only go this far, and so they stay there, their point of safety, and think, oh, I can't paint, and then retract back. And actually what you need to do is you need to say, actually, if I can go this far, what happens here? Because the point of failure is probably actually way over here. So there's this magic area in between where you never explore because you think you can't do it and you're full of insecurity. So it's quite nice to get children to do that from a young age and get them to just explore paint. And there's no traditional way of doing it, you know. I chuck it on and I'll show you what's happened this morning. You can see, I'm getting my head in the iPad in order to see. Hopefully you can see some of the marks that are on there. I forgot to do a time lapse, so I'm going to do one of the next bit, but I've just taken a photograph of it so I can decide what to do on it next. Oh, look at that. Yeah, when I did filming the other day, I had ink on my face. It looks like I've got chocolate, but it's not, it's ink. So yeah, I'll do a time lapse and we'll see what happens next. But it's very much about experimenting. Experimenting today, can you see? And seeing what happens next. And not trying to get too caught up in the fact that I did a good painting yesterday that I liked, but instead get caught up on the properties of the paints that are there and the colours and the mark making that's there instead. And give it a go, see what happens. So hopefully the next bit you'll see won't be a disaster, it'll be a wonderful success, but who knows. Good progress made today with painting. I've been doing as artist in residence at Slimbridge. Lots of sunshine, so lots of light shining on the water, which is really what I needed today. And I've got some abstract areas in the foreground to really tackle. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do them yet, but I'm really looking forward to them because I know they're going to help to pull it together and I can get my palette knife out and paint nice and thickly. But yeah, lots of resolve today, so I'm really, really pleased that I managed to get so much done and get so much resolved, because I wasn't expecting to. So I've got to decide tomorrow whether to paint this one or to paint the Sir Peter Scott one. I don't know. Decisions. Nice problem to be stuck with. This is a painting from today. So you can see my focus has been light again and capturing those reflections on water. Wanted to keep it nice and loose in the background area and give that impression of light filtering through trees, and then really starting to bring some deep, dark, dense areas into the foreground. It's quite a lot unresolved on this side here, and this has been left blank because I want some nice abstract. I'll show you actually these grasses and teasels we've got here in the foreground. You can see actually lend themselves really nicely to creating some nice abstract shapes in the foreground, which should help to pull the whole composition together. Hopefully you can see most of it now. So lots to do, but quite a lot of lovely marks in amongst the controlled chaos that is often my paintings.